NUS has recently launched the NUS AI Institute, which seeks to foster a vibrant ecosystem that promotes synergistic AI research and applications, and grow the talent pool and engage government and industry in partnerships. We have also built in innovation and entrepreneurship as well. So it looks to advance the research, development, and application of AI technologies for the benefit of society, and in many areas such as education, healthcare, finance, and so on.
在看片之前，大家记得分享、赞好和订阅灼见名家，最紧要揿埋呢个钟仔，咁你就唔会错过我哋嘅最新影片。
I'm going to talk about AI in education. I'm delighted to be in good company for this session and share about the fast-growing and unavoidable phenomenon that higher education institutions across the world must manage. That is the use of artificial intelligence, or AI. AI has stormed the gates of higher education, especially in the last year or so. This acceleration can be attributed to the launch of ChatGPT in late 2022. For those who work in the area of AI, I think ChatGPT or large language models or generative AI, this is just a small part of the huge tapestry of AI research. Now, the third chatbot Global Student Survey indicates that, and they poll undergraduates across 15 countries last year, and they shared that over 40% of respondents have used generative AI for their studies. And of those students, 50%, half of them, have inputted a question into general AI tools once a day or more. So without a doubt, these figures are set to grow as learners are introduced to AI tools much earlier. Learning and thinking form the foundations of education. Given the rising use and increased reliance of AI in educational institutions, I think it is important for us to ensure that the development of intellectual skills of our learners are not compromised. For example, it is typical for us to search online for information through search engines such as Google, pick up the relevant materials and consolidate them. But this task is now delegated to ChatGPT that has developed the capability to source, to extract, and to consolidate relevant information on any topics. And as a result, it eliminates the need for human agency. So there is the danger that if learners grow overly dependent on AI tools, that sort of foundational skill may be lost. So we stand at a cusp of the next industrial revolution, where our students, our graduates, will play a very critical role. And this is a role in the age of intelligence built into anything. So in the age of AI, technology will disrupt the fundamental value propositions of higher education, our curriculum, on what we teach and what we want our students to learn, and also pedagogy, how we teach and how our students learn and how we as professors assess. Tertiary education in particular must be reimagined to stay relevant. Educators should inculcate a high level of AI literacy by integrating AI concepts, applications, and implications across different disciplines so that our learners can build a multi-dimensional understanding of AI and its relevance and also its applications across many fields. They also need to reboot and repivot by incorporating the use of technology and AI in their teaching methods. Now, this requires a move from our traditional teacher-focused, skills-based, product-oriented, non-less interactive, and also highly prescribed way of learning, and to take a more hands-on approach that is more student or learner-centric. Now, at NUS, we have developed an interim policy way back early last year on how to encourage the use of AI in teaching and learning, and to establish some good guidelines for both our teachers and our learners. So for instance, generating an output and presenting it as one's own work would constitute an improper use of AI. We have also configured an AI community or practice to exchange ideas, to share resources, and to promote best practices, and set also community standards for the teaching of AI and application of AI in education. Now, beyond imparting knowledge and skills, educators should also see themselves as guides and leverage on AI to cultivate and hone higher level cognitive skills such as critical thinking, analysis, and strategy in learners. So this aligns very well with the 2023 Future of Jobs report by the World Economic Forum, where cognitive skills they top the list of important skill sets for our learners. Critical thinking skills include having an astute knowledge of what AI tools are capable of, as well as their shortcomings. Now, this would enable our learners to ask relevant and specific queries, leading to improved outcomes and deeper insights. To understand and handle the algorithms powering AI tools, learners must also grasp the basics of computational thinking, which is a mode of problem solving in mathematics, which is also the basis of prompt engineering, which these days you see are coupled together with the use of ChatGPT. So in doing so, I think it is important for educators and learners alike to be able to link theory and practice, and importantly, with hands-on projects. Additionally, an increased and more meaningful engagement with learners will allow educators the opportunity to emphasize humanities in education, which include navigating the nuances of human interaction, empathy, and ethical decision-making. The advancement of AI has also paved the way for personalized learning, where learners are empowered to dictate their learning goals, their pace of learning, how they learn, and more. Now, this is a depiction of a survey with just over 3,000 high school and college students in the United States. And it revealed that nearly all have replaced some of their tutoring sessions with ChatGPT. And 9 out of 10 respondents indicate a preference for studying with ChatGPT than with a personal tutor. So given that AI will likely displace large numbers of blue collar and also the bottom rung of white collar, we think that one of the biggest challenges is in the continuing education and training sector. Because this is where we would need to retrain and reskill displaced workers and to provide them with new meaningful career pathways. As an institution, NUS has also rolled out university-wide courses for our own administration staff, such as data literacy programs and AI competency courses to keep them up to date and to empower them to leverage on new technologies. So, AI is here to stay. We might as well accept and embrace it and ensure that we develop AI-ready students who are both technically adept and ethically responsible in their use of AI. Now, for research-intensive universities like NUS, AI can also play a significant part in expediting research. Harnessing the full potential of AI requires the development of multidisciplinary and interdisciplinary teams, and also an enhancement of our research infrastructure to boost the computing power. So in this particular regard, NUS has recently launched the NUS AI Institute, which seeks to foster a vibrant ecosystem that promotes synergistic AI research and applications, and grow the talent pool and engage government and industry in partnerships. And we have also built in innovation and entrepreneurship as well. So it looks to advance the research, development, and application of AI technologies for the benefit of society, and in many areas such as education, healthcare, finance, and so on. It will also organize its research activities under four trusts: foundational AI research, application domain research, policy and society implications, as well as the AI infrastructure. Now, to drive innovation and research translation, we are partnering with industry. For a start, IBM and Google Cloud will be collaborating with the NUS AI Institute as industry partners for research and domain applications and development. Now, unquestionably, there are some inherent risks in the use of AI tools, from inaccurate information to inherited biases in data, as well as intellectual property and copyright issues. As such, regulation will have to move in tandem with technology developments and must be considered from different angles, from data collection to model training to model output, right, end to end. So in view of AI's voracious appetite for energy, another major consideration is its impact on environment. All right, at just NUS, our servers are housed within 3 data centers, and they expend about 12 gigawatt hours every year. And this is about 30% of which come from our GPU servers. And this is now about 5% of our annual electricity usage. But this is likely to grow, to double, to triple, right, in the next few years. So NUS hopes to reduce our carbon footprint by 30% by 2030. And with the increased use of AI for education and research, we are actually seeking more efficient ways to cool our data centers. So numerous prototypes have been put in place, including one, the Sustainable Tropical Data Center Testbed, which is, I think, one of the world's first tropical climate data center. So in conclusion, AI, machine learning, and deep learning will fundamentally change the future of work, living, and learning. It is thus vital for all of us to step up on how we integrate AI into our program, into the thoughts of our people, and into what we do. This requires really a shift in mindset from merely assessing AI's capabilities and implications to improving and refining the way how we use it, and hopefully bridging the gap from fearing AI to befriending AI. As man and machine compete for dominance, higher education institutions have a very key role to play in ensuring that human intelligence remains supreme over machine. Thank you very much.
鍾意名家分析，记得俾 like 同埋分享，支持同订阅卓见名家，最紧要揿埋呢个钟仔，咁就唔会错过我哋嘅新片。